You're listening to Con Talk, and this is episode number 45. It's going to be a short one. We are going to be discussing MonsterCon, which took place this past weekend. But before we get started, allow me to introduce my co-host for this episode. To my left, we have returning for the first time since our Fiesta Equestria podcast, we have AJ.
Howdy, howdy.
And to my right is our original gangster of the year, other original gangster of Con Talk, Chris Holm.
Yeah, they called me the Hatchet Man last time or something like that.
Yeah, that's right. You're the Hatchet Man. I'm the Straight Man.
Cowboy Man.
Cowboyman, yeah, I guess.
Hatman, for Hatman.
Ooh, Hatman, there you go. There you go, like we're all Mega Man villains or something.
I throw hats at you.
So yeah, MonsterCon, which took place September 26th through the 27th at the Wonderland of the Americas Mall in San Antonio, Texas. This is a NDG Productions event. That's one of those free events that happens at the mall every so often. In the past, I've described it as, you know, probably their best event. They put a little more effort into it. They get some minor guests to show up, you know, which is nice. I was there as a vendor, and you, Chris, and AJ, all were there, you know, just acting normal and...
I was not acting normal. I was in my Deadpool cosplay, like, the first time in a long time, so I was pretty happy with it.
Well, that's because I had to coax you into dressing up, because at first you weren't even dressed up, and you're like, well, I don't know. I'm like, dude, come on, man.
Yeah, it was actually worth it, because they're, like mess with little kids, kind of, like, pull out a, like, sword and, like, slap around a bit, and they would, like, come at me. I'm like, oh my god, and I fall down on the ground, and I die.
Yeah, that was cute. You gotta make some little kids happy.
Yeah, there was, like, a lot of very family-friendly, a lot of kids there. So if you, like, you know, have a more family-friendly kind of cosplay, that's a place to showcase it.
There were a lot of, like, not family-friendly, well, not family, but incredibly scary cosplays. They had a few really good clowns from American Horror Story that, by far, I think the scariest character, you know, like, if you guys haven't seen it.
Well, clowns in general.
Yeah, clowns are always scary. Yeah,
but this one, like, if you haven't seen the show, in part of it, they show a graphic representation of him putting a shotgun to his mouth and blowing it off and not dying. So, yeah, that was this clown. They had two of them there. And they had a few, like, other giant scary ones, I think Hannibal Lecter, too. So, yeah, not bad overall.
Yeah, there's a nice little variety of costumes.
But if you like horror, a lot of small kids don't like horror. And if they do, I'm kind of concerned for their souls. But again, very good cosplays.
They'll grow out of it. Come on.
They can only shit their pants once.
Yeah, there you go.
I like that. That's just be a motto for a horror con. You can only crap your pants once. So come here.
Actually, that needs to be a tagline for a movie. I don't know what kind of movie. I'm not sure I want to see it. But that needs to be a tagline somewhere. It's a horror-themed convention. You know, people dressing up, you know, in the spirit, if you will, of the, you know, convention. The vendors, you know, it's usually your typical variety of, you know, mostly nerd stuff. One of my constant complaints, and I think I'm the only one that's bothered by this, is, you know, the occasional not, you know, convention-themed vendor that, you know, breaks the magic a little bit.
Yeah, the Sensi vendor.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. So for the uneducated ones, what is a Sensi?
It's like a warmer thing. Or, you know, you get the little wax cubes and you put it in the warmer thing and it melts and it makes your house smell nice.
Yeah. That aroma fragrance type stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
So basically incense without incense.
Something like that, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, like I said, they're like little, I mean, they sell them all over the place now. And like I said, they're like, I think, little wax cubes or something. You put them in the top thing, you turn it on, it, you know, there's like a light bulb and it heats up and slowly melts it. And like I said, here.
See, when I was in high school, my mom had something similar to that. It was just a waxless or flameless candle and it would heat up from the bottom. And you know those giant Yankee candles?
Right.
And so it'd heat up all the way, and it'd be completely full of wax, and I'd stick my hand in it. Because I was bored in the morning when we were getting ready to go for school, so I'd have a wax hand before school.
It's what you do when you live in a small town, kids.
I live in Houston!
Oh, okay, well, it's
just bored.
You're just weird then, yeah.
Exactly.
That's the kind of stuff that we do in a small town. Jeez. It's a free convention. It's basically, you know, they take a bunch of vendors and pile them into the mall. They have a stage where they have, you know, performers playing throughout the day and DJs and...
A lot of belly dancing.
Make that sound like a bad thing.
Yeah, that's like there was quite a bit. And the sound system wasn't the same sound system that they had last year or a year prior.
Well, it didn't seem to be as loud.
Yeah, it didn't seem to be as loud because before, I think they would have, I don't know, some DJ come in from Austin. Yeah. I forget what her name was, DJ Crescent Roll or something. I can't think of the name, but she had a really good system, and she would bring in her DJ system, she would play music, and they would do announcements and stuff. Mm-hmm. And that was great, that was wonderful. This time, it's like the whatever their sound system was just wasn't up to par.
Well, you know, there might be a reason for that, because I do know at Minicon, that they did have some complaints about the, you know, the volume of the music. Though I think upon further review, it may have been the type of music as opposed to the volume.
Mm-hmm.
You know, apparently the older generation is less enamored with electronic music, you know.
I do not like EDM, and I'm not part of the older generation. It's just noise to me.
Mm.
And I, you know, I can't dance. I'm super white, but whatever.
Yep.
How do you even dance to? I don't
know. Again, I don't know. I can't do it.
You got me, man.
Yeah, pretty much.
I would not necessarily see that as a bad thing, though, because usually the music's too loud.
It served the purpose. I mean, you know, it was good for the performances.
Yeah, I mean, if you were down there around the stage, I mean, you could hear, you know, the music, whatever was going on.
Yeah, when it got freaking loud was when the School of Rock came in.
Oh, there you go.
And started playing, you know, live music with live instruments. And again, they brought in their own sound system, was what I think it was. And you know, and live music sounds loud anyway, so they made it obnoxiously loud.
Well, there you go.
That's kind of what you, you know, which is what you expect of live music.
Anything in particular that, like, stood out for you that y'all liked? that you saw at the show?
I don't know. Okay, so for MonsterCon, for me, it's not a convention. It's more of a bazaar that has like two panels. And
that's a fair statement.
And so again, I go there, just kind of like browse around. Not really. I like doing window shopping, and so that's what I do. MonsterCon is great for that. I mean, there was some cool stuff. I did buy those two maple bacon cupcakes or whatever. That was pretty good.
Those were good.
Yeah, but it was okay.
Yeah, I mean, and it's nice that you can take a break and rest your feet up at the food court. And, you know, they have a good selection of restaurants there with different types of foods, you know, pizza, burgers, and all that stuff.
They didn't have tacos, though, and that's what I was looking for.
Yeah, he had a sign and everything, you know, we'll work for tacos. Yeah. There are no tacos to be found.
I mean, if someone brought me a taco...
Would you settle for a kebab? They did have a new kebab shop.
This little kid jumped up and says, I'm going to hire you. How many tacos will it take? I'm like, what are you going to hire me for? He's like, I don't know. I'm like, then find out. And I walked away. So no, again, honestly, it was a good crowd overall. I think it was a bit...
I thought so.
I think it was more well-attended this year than past and previous
years.
Yeah,
it definitely looked a lot more fuller than this year.
Yeah, there was a brief gap around probably, I guess, 3 or 4 hours from like 1 or 2 to like 5 when it was, you know, got like really crowded downstairs.
It actually looked like a well-attended mall. Once, and it's like ever.
I say that every time we bring these things up. I mean,
there was a good audience on Sunday, and Saturday was just a phenomenal audience. Mm-hmm. Just tons of people.
So definitely from an attendee standpoint, I mean, it seemed to be a really good event.
Yeah, I mean, I went there. I had fun. There was lots of, you know, I mean, they had a lot of canvas painted artists and stuff, and you just see a bunch of different stuff. A lot of it was geared towards younger kids and stuff, and there was some stuff, a lot of Mad Max stuff, which I really liked, which was cool. Mm-hmm. And, you know, a lot of different, I mean, they had like a bunch of different vendors, but the really creative ones had a bunch of different stuff.
Yeah.
And that was just, it was really blew me away.
One guy selling, it was like furry ears and art and My Little Pony stuff as well. And he really kind of like diversified. Yeah, I know the guy that Awkward Harley Quinn got her ears from, right?
I think so.
Yeah.
Because they're down the road from me on the second floor, right?
Yeah.
I think I know who you're talking about.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Again, I honestly, the worst part was that awkward Harley Quinn that came up to us. With that creep.
For me.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie. I was weirded out of it, too.
What? What did I miss?
Okay, so we're at my table.
Yeah.
And, go figure. I haven't started, you know, bitching about it yet. You know, we're just hanging out, and a girl comes by. I think she was a boyfriend or significant other was with her. Yeah, and we started talking, and, you know, she's like, well, I'm a zombie. He's like, okay, cool. Yeah, but I'm a famous zombie. I'm dressed up like somebody from, you know...
She said, I'm someone's boyfriend.
Yeah, not the bad guy, but the bad guy's boyfriend.
And I'm thinking, girlfriend, I'm like, what zombie is in either Marvel or DC universe that is famous? I'm just trying to think of, like, famous zombie that has a girlfriend that doesn't, like, maybe... I don't know.
Yeah, we're grasping at straws, and then she's like, well, I'm from DC.
And then
you point me out, like, well, you're the DC guy. Yeah. You need to know.
Yeah, so, I sell you down.
You are the DC guy.
I sell you down. I do not care.
Yeah, nobody complains when I lend you all my videos, right? So I saw she was wearing a red and black bow in her hair. I couldn't see the stockings.
Yeah.
So I just saw red and black and just took a guess. Okay, Harley Quinn. You're like, yeah, it's a Harley Quinn.
No one has ever guessed that this entire convention. She's wearing like a black shirt with like creepers are fun and like a fake scar on her neck. I'm like, how would we ever guess that you were Harley Quinn? She's like, I didn't tell her that, but she's like, my stockings are like Harley Quinn and they were, you know, red and black.
And the diamonds.
Like, if we have to think about it, it's not a good cosplay. And I've done those bad cosplays before, but people have gotten it eventually. I've had my Big Mac, the red shirt, and belt buckle, my hat. It always has to have the hat. But yeah, people have gotten it before.
But that's a pony thing. I mean, normal people won't know that.
I know. Some did. Most don't. I'm happy with that.
Yeah, incidentally, this is, I think, is the first time in a while that I have two bronies on the show. Remember you and Damon way back when?
Yes.
Giving me shit.
Yeah.
I enjoyed the show. I was a little disappointed as well because I was essentially in Mos Eisley. Upstairs, because all the cool stuff, and I told people this several times during the event, I'm saying, you know, all the cool stuff is downstairs. You know, this is just like extra vendors. It was kind of nice because I paid a reduced cost for my table, half price, $50 versus $100.
Oh, yeah, because you were registered under an artist.
Right, artist,
writer.
They're
artists and vendors. And
yeah, they wanted people that did art or that did, you know, writing, you know, that did, you know, like creative things versus, you know, oh, I made, you know, Iron Man out of pipe cleaners or whatever. They didn't want that. You know, if you wanted to sell your Iron Man made out of pipe cleaners, you had to pay $100 to get the other table.
I kind of like that, actually. Like, judge the artist based off of, like, how good their stuff is or how, like, unique and, like, not how much we have there.
Well, I don't know if that was it exactly. I think it's, like, the vendors were selling the licensed products. Like,
the fan art
dolls, the action figures, you know, stuff that you could get at Walmart.
Yeah.
Right, or old, you know, old comic book issues yada, yada. You know, versus, you know, creative people doing, you know,
making
their fan art or different
things.
The
DIY.
Or short stories.
Creatives that actually make the products.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So I get there early Saturday. And the first thing I noticed when I, you know, hauling my stuff up there is like, holy cats, it was warm upstairs.
Even before everyone got there.
Yeah, exactly. This is like 9:15, Saturday morning, and I'm already starting to break a sweat. And I'm like, is the air conditioning in this thing even on? okay, fine. So, you know, I rattle on over to where I think my spot is, and there's somebody else, like, partially set up in my spot. Yeah, and I'm like, ah, crap. You know, so...
Okay, so just to be clear, were the spots assigned? Did you receive a map and an email previously?
Yeah, they sent out an email with a map of the upstairs and downstairs, you know, with numbers on the map, you know, and you are this number. Like, I'm number 33.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is where you are, you know, which is the right thing to do. What they didn't do is that they did not...
Number the spots?
They did not, you know, they didn't number the spots. They didn't mark off on the floor, you know, with painter's tape, you know, like how big your spot was or how much space you had. But they did do that downstairs. Downstairs was all taped off, and I saw numbers.
Ouch.
And it's like, okay, so was this, you know, it just felt like it was an afterthought. It's like, we'll just leave those, you know, but whatever happens, happens. And I was genuinely worried because, I mean, I kind of got over the whole they were in my spot thing pretty quickly because, I mean, I'm not one to, you know, make a big stink about things.
Yeah, you're not willing to be the bad guy. Huh?
Well, not in that context.
Yeah, but that's what...
Because I'm not at work. I do enough of being the bad guy at work.
Yeah, I totally would have fought for it. But yeah. That's me, you know.
No, and I get it. I mean, you know, if you're...
That's why I don't go back to very many cons. It's because, like, oh, crap. He's going to start trouble.
You know, okay, fine. I mean, my expectations for the show are pretty low anyway. And they had a lot of stuff, so they kind of did need some room. So it's like, that's fine. Whatever. You know, I'll let it go. You know, we basically swapped.
Hmm.
But, of course, they had the better spots. It was on the edge. But, whatever. But I did let the organizers know that, you know, hey, y'all need to keep an eye on things up here because nothing's marked off. And I'm going to let it go, but some other people may not be as accommodating. You know, somebody might raise a fuss and
someone probably did, you know, raise a fuss.
Wouldn't doubt it. I didn't hear anything, but I didn't really talk to a whole lot of folks either.
Mm-hmm.
And so I, given what I've heard about the convention and, you know, that I've gone in previous years and enjoyed it and had a good time. And like I said, I don't think we've ever really talked really badly about any of the NDG events on the show. I was disappointed. You know, I expected a well-run event, you know, especially given how often they do it. And they just totally let me down. They just totally dropped the ball.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And this isn't, you know,
the first time.
They're not rookies at this point.
Yeah, exactly. They've been doing this thing for, the third one?
Yeah, the third or the fourth. Right?
Yeah, this is like the third or fourth MonsterCon. Mm-hmm. And then they do other events throughout the year, so it's like, you know, come on, guys. I mean, y'all should be on the ball by now.
Yeah, it should be a well-oiled machine at this point.
I think what happened was that they kind of overextended themselves
mm-hmm.
in trying to, because my understanding is that they basically filled up the mall, you know, with stuff, with people, with vendors. Frankly, I think they overdid it a bit because don't get me wrong, there was traffic. There wasn't quite as much traffic upstairs, I'm guessing, because number one, there was nothing to really draw people upstairs, just the spirit store, and that was like down on the other side, away from all the vendors. You know, there's no con-related stuff. Like on one side, you had the stage downstairs, and the other side, you have like the Power Rangers table, you have, you know, the karaoke cosplay people.
I saw Spider-Man dancing downstairs, little kids.
There you go. You know, they had stuff to, you know, get people moving. It's like, oh, the celebrities are over behind the stage.
Yeah, they got like photo booths and stuff like that.
Yeah, stuff to draw people, you know, make people walk around and check out all the neat stuff. Well, upstairs there is no neat stuff, you know, or at least con-related neat stuff.
Yeah, there's no like photo op places or photo services or any type of thing like that was spread out downstairs.
Yeah,
it
exactly.
Look like, yeah.
And it didn't help. And I don't know, I think the biggest problem with these events is the mall itself.
Yeah.
You know, because the air conditioning just couldn't keep up. You know, I get that, you know, they're trying to get people to come to the mall and see, you know, oh, you know, we're back in business, yada yada, but it's like two of the escalators were busted.
Sorry, why do they rope off the escalators? There's still stairs. Okay, like, an escalator doesn't break, it just turns into more stairs. You'd have people going up it, just making it an up arrow. Like, you can't, like, no, do not enter, put, like, a sign there saying it goes this one way.
Liability?
I don't know.
It's probably liability, I guess.
Probably furries.
No, because ours were made stairs. At that first TFF, they were in the new hotel.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then they got grease in everybody's feet paws and yada yada, but that's another, that was another story. You know, I get that they're trying to, you know, put an effort into improving the place, but between the air conditioning and the escalators not working and half the damn bathroom fixtures not working, it's like, come on, guys. I mean, you know, this is your chance to shine and, you know, show everybody you're back in business, and it's, you know, not as nice as it should be.
Meh.
Yeah.
I mean, that mall's never, I think it's not a bad location. It's just...
No, it's a great location.
Yeah, but I don't know what's wrong with it. Like, oh, there's a mall in Omaha, Crossroads Mall.
Okay, that's weird.
What?
Well, the previous name of that mall was Crossroads Mall.
That is creepy.
But carry on.
All right, the only reason why you go to this location is by far the best location. It's at 72nd and Dodge, super busy all the time, like all the other stores around it are packed. But this mall is just deserted. It has all these empty stores. There's the only thing that's open is the Fairy Tale Costume Shop. And it stays in business year-round. I don't know how. That and the Target. That's it. So it's
not even a Chick-fil-A?
They got a Chick-fil-A, not in that mall,
uh-huh.
but in Omaha, and it was like in a small place. It was packed the first day. Omaha takes a little while to catch up.
I know people that have stores in the mall. I want to see them, you know, succeed and do well and all that good stuff. But, you know, the mall's not exactly helping their case.
Yeah.
It's like, it kind of feels like they were kind of starting on something and then they ran out of money.
Could be. Who knows?
Eh.
Who knows? But once again, the event itself, you know, outside of those little, you know, complaints, I had fun. I talked to, you know, quite a number of people on Saturday, saw lots of friends, including you two. You know, even with those, you know, quibbles, you know, I had fun. I had a good time. You know, the cost of the table was reasonable.
Like, despite your location, you were right in front of the completely glass wall of Burlington Coat Factory.
Yeah, that was funny.
You just see people going on, and it's funny. People are trying on these heavy jackets in Texas, where currently it is now, like, 87 degrees when the sun is down. And I'm like, why would you need this jacket at all? Yeah, what's the temperature outside?
It says 78, but I don't know how accurate this thing is.
Yeah, 78, but still, this is the sundown. It's been down for about an hour.
Yeah, it's 9 o'clock.
You're not going to need heavy coats. I'm wearing shorts right now, so.
Yeah, I think we're all, well, I'm wearing shorts and...
No, he's wearing jeans. Chris is the odd man out.
Weirdo. Yeah.
Well, I mean, you know,
HEB t-shirt.
It's like we
we rare, get it. You work at HEB. Yeah,
we rarely have winter here. When we do,
so
it,
you got to be ready.
Yeah, it only lasts like a couple days anyway. But it was funny because we would see our friends go through there, and it was kind of like people watching.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you get to watch them shop, and we get to poke fun at them as they try on coats that don't fit.
Well, one thing I noticed that was kind of funny was some people, I guess, were like just going straight into the Burlington Coat Factory from outside. I believe I think there's a door, and they would like look out. You know, and I'm wearing my bear ears. They'll kind of look out, and they'd be like, "The hell's that?" You know, just wondering, or they see people walking around in the costumes and just kind of, you know, they get this double take of,
yeah,
you know, ooh, scary clown, what's a scary clown doing walking around in the mall, so, or Freddy Krueger or whatever.
So basically we were a zoo.
Yeah, pretty much.
Awesome.
Speaking of zoo.
Damn furries.
There was some petting zoo, like, thing there, or,
was it? Could,
yeah, there was a live owl in the panel room.
There's an owl?
Oh, yeah,
that you
Sunday.
Could take a picture with, Luna the owl.
Oh my god, I totally would have taken a picture with that owl. Damn it.
It was nice. It was real pretty as well. It was funny because, Dave Hankin and the San Japan table were set up in front of where the owl was at, and I remember all the... There's like, you know, just clear glass window. And Dave was like, yeah, people keep just like staring at the owl. And I'm like, well, yeah, it hardly ever moves. You know,
I thought it was a statue at first.
Yeah, exactly. And I was staring at it. I'm like, okay, is that a, you know, is it alive or is it just a stuffed owl or is it a statue or whatever there? And then it, you know, blinks or, you know, does the weirdo rotated head all the way around thing. It's like, okay, it's alive.
And it's a demon.
Yeah, you know? And it's like people would walk up to the San Japan and be like, oh my God, is that owl real? You know, and
mm-hmm. like pet it, see what happens.
Yeah. Poke your eye out.
And some people would, you know, just take a picture of the owl through the glass and, that was so unethical. That's like stealing.
Yeah, Dave did one. He did a selfie, or as I would call it, an owlie.
An owlie.
It's like, owl.
So you had to pay to take a picture with the owl?
Yeah, I think it's like $5. Yeah, so was it from like the zoo or something?
I think it was some kind of preserve or something. Some kind of preserve organization.
Yeah, I forgot to check into that. Like who it was from, you know what I mean?
Nice.
It was like an aviary or...
Speaking of the panel room, can we get to the panels?
Yeah, go ahead. Go nuts, because I didn't go to any because I was at my table.
There were panels? What?
Yeah, well, I was pretty much like the only person that went to the panels.
Well, weren't you there to see somebody?
Yeah,
some
I was there,
art guy?
I was, one of the visiting panelists was Drew Edwards. He was who does Halloween Man. And you know, I see him at shows, but I never actually get a chance to actually talk to him. And he was doing panels. Like, oh, cool. Okay, cool. I'll check him out. And he came in and did a panel.
And but you were like the only one there?
Yeah, and I was the only one there. It was just me and the only other guy that was there to set up for the next panel, which was EMP, Supernatural, Paranormal, whatever's.
Okay.
And, you know, it's nice because basically the entire panel was just me and him having a conversation, going through shop talk, which is, you know, which was great because I actually got to talk to the guy one-on-one.
Hmm.
But, you know, that's like, that's kind of as far as how the panels are organized. I mean, they would print out sheets with the schedule and they would post them up on the sides of the door. I mean, on the sides of the panel room, and they would post them like throughout the pillars in the mall.
Yeah, but unless you're like looking for them.
Yeah, but it's just regular 8x10 paper and, you know, and.
Yeah, you're not going to notice it.
Yeah, you're not going to notice. Other than that, the only advertising for the panels was through social media.
Right. And right on your Facebook and all that.
Yeah, and
the website.
Most people are probably going to be skipping that because they're just going to be seeing posts about, oh, I'm at the mall, or check out my costumes and stuff like that. So you're going to miss any kind of scheduling.
Yeah, I mean, that's something that's always kind of bugged me in general about the events is that they need to do a better job of letting people know that there are panels, you know, there's stuff to check out while you're there.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it just needs to find a better way of advertising it during the convention.
Yeah, maybe put something on those electric signs that they have now.
That would be a good idea, you know. Or
even just a bigger, like, bulletin board thing with, you know, panels.
Yeah,
you know?
Like, panels. Here, like, didn't they,
you know, here's our schedule.
I thought they had, like, one that said Last Con. Was it MonsterCon? Or is Last Con at that?
You might be thinking of Mini-Mini-Con.
It might have been Mini-Mini. They had panels on, like, the board saying, these are what we have for today, at what time, at what room. I'm like, oh, that's great. I know where Furry 101 is.
That was Mini-Mini-Con. That's the San Japan folks.
Well, let's go make fun of Ed there.
Yeah, funny guy.
Yeah, that's
funny guy. Like, I don't get enough of that from Shecker and Wolfboy.
Yeah, that's different organizers, though. But what I would have suggested then was maybe have someone, you know, just walk through the mall with a loudspeaker and just announce the panels, right, maybe like 15 minutes before they start.
Yeah, or over the PA even.
Well, they really didn't have a PA other than what was playing the music that was on the stage. They really
right, which we already established wasn't exactly the best. But.
Yeah. I mean, so it was kind of like a missed opportunity.
Yeah, and it's a little bit it's a bit of a shame because they had a pretty good, you know, little variety of different panels. Yeah. Like you had the comic book guy, you had the I was going to say supernatural, but I know that doesn't quite right.
Well, yeah, there are
ghost hunting. Paranormal. There you go. Paranormal people.
Ghost hunting people.
You know, I think one of the writers had a panel. I mean, you know, they had a variety of stuff, but they just didn't advertise it enough at the event, or at least, you know, not big enough for people to see. Because like I said, you know, get a bulletin board or something.
Yeah, because they were still good panels. I mean, it's kind of a missed opportunity.
Yeah,
there.
Exactly. Because like I said, it's stuff, you know, it's an opportunity for those people to, you know, show off their stuff or share what they do. You know, and it's also an opportunity for people that are there, you know, to learn about different things. You know, maybe you're curious about the paranormal.
Yeah, because I'm pretty sure a lot of the people there would have been interested in, had they known.
Yeah, exactly. So.
And I mean, because they had like a little tabletop gaming section that was there, and people would go into there and they would go and they'd have their fun. I did see a few signs for the art show, which was to point into the lobby outside of the movie theater where there were more artists. So that was some signage.
See, I didn't even know there was anybody out there. Yeah. Of course, I didn't take the opportunity to, you know, walk down out there because. You know, I don't want to leave my table completely alone.
Yeah, I mean, there were a few signs, but, you know, they were kind of small. I guess I'd have to suggest, you know, maybe, you know, add color to it, because it's just, you know, black and white printed on and put it on there, and that's not going to work.
Along with the tabletop gaming, did the convention put on a chess room, or is that just...
No, that's like a chess club that has set up shop in the mall.
Oh, okay, I was wondering, like, why are there so many chess boards in this one room?
And, like, and there was, like, a gigantic chess board.
Yeah, that kind of seemed fun. I kind of wanted to go in and, like, knock some stuff down, but I'm like, that could not good.
No, I think there's, like, a chess club or something that... You can go and learn how to play chess or play chess with people.
Because that used
talk
to be
chess things.
That used to be the Obamacare station.
Right.
They still have the Obamacare hours posted on the door.
Oh, that's awesome.
And it's like, yeah, I'd like to see people go in there. They probably won't get Obamacare, but they'll...
They will, but you have to win.
They'll know how to check it. It's like, you got to check first to get your benefits.
Yep.
And when we say check, we mean check me.
I think overall, you know, like I said, my minor complaints aside, you know, it was a good event. I mean, everybody I know had fun.
Yeah, and, you know, and whatever qualms we had are easily, you know...
Well, I don't know about easily, because like I said, to me, the big thing is the mall.
Yeah.
You know, number one, the mall needs to, you know, spend some money and get that AC going and fix everything. And number two, you know, they need to either, you know, put a little more effort into getting people to go upstairs for whatever reason, you know, or limit the size of the event.
Yeah.
You know, because not everybody's going to walk around the entire mall when you have all the cool stuff clustered in that one
hallway.
Or just
keep it to the one floor.
Yeah, exactly. You know, or that, yeah, right, there you go.
May be like a little bit crowded, but you know it's. I mean, they
well,
have,
less
they
is
can
more.
Have room, you know.
You know, less is more.
Probably
I think
better organized. They should know by now the flow of traffic of everything, and where would be the best places to put stuff.
Yeah, I think so. Anything final, AJ?
Again, it's more of a bazaar, not a con. Those are my personal things. The fact
I'm inclined to agree.
The fact that it's free just still just baffles me. Since I've run a few cons, I don't know how you do something with that small a budget. But then again, they don't really have any major guests, so yeah.
Let's talk about the guests. The celebrities, the celebrities they had from Nightmare on Elm Street. There was a girl from Jurassic World. I don't know. Pull it up. The science. I want to see who I missed.
Okay, well, because, it says something that you know you didn't even go to check them out.
Yeah, I'm
locked at my I'm stuck at my table.
Yeah,
I know what your excuse was.
Well,
I was Deadpool.
I was
you're Office Pool.
Office Pool. One kid got that right. He says you're Office Deadpool. I'm like yes. Small 5-year-old children know who I am. Then I also got called Ant-Man and Spider-Man a few times. But you know what? Don't care.
Take it.
I was in the panels. I was too busy going to panels to check out the celebrities.
And AJ was busy entertaining children.
And then giving shots on Sunday, so I was hurting children. But whatever.
And that's the balance of the universe is maintained.
It was at a Buddhist temple, man. I had to maintain balance. Yeah. Oh,
okay.
Yeah, got invited out to the Vietnamese picnic afterwards.
Okay, the website is totally not... It's derping out, or my internet is derping out, because the website's not coming up at all. So we may be...
Weren't you just there?
Yeah, I was just there. But it's not coming up now. You have a phone, man. Use the Google.
I left my phone in my room.
You came directly from work.
No, I went home and I took a shower.
And you kept on your same shirt?
No, this is a different shirt. I have more than one work shirt. Well, right, this isn't even technically a work shirt. They gave it to us for good behavior.
Okay, here we go. The web page appears to be coming up now. Vendor and artist list. Am I even on the list?
Celebrities.
Hold on.
Vendors and artists.
I'm not on the list. What the hell?
You're not important enough.
Apparently
special
not.
Guest, Ken
just,
Segos.
Just what I need is something else to complain about, not on the damn website.
Ken Segos is from Nightmare on Elm Street 4 and 3.
Yeah, he played the character of Kincaid. Let's see, I think he was like the big, you know, the big guest.
All I got.
Okay, I've got the page up now. Tim Miller, who's an author. Osvaldo Fernandez.
What is he in?
Okay, well, I'm getting there, man. he's an actor. He appeared in Jurassic World, G.I. Joe Retaliation, Sim City, A Dame to Kill For. You know, and a number of other movies, Machete 2, he was second season of Dallas, so he's done, you know, a few shows.
That's cool. We'll probably have to watch those movies more closely.
Okay, Michael Fellon, a first-time guest actor based out of Austin, was in American Crime, The Leftovers, From Dusk Till Dawn, seasons 1 and 2. Let's see, Joe Lozano, another actor, Machete Kills, Leftovers Season 2 from Dusk Till Dawn, American Crime, Parrish Randall from Circus of the Dead, Possum Walk.
I'm looking for stuff I've seen.
Yeah, well, I'm trying. Gillian O'Daniel was a cosplay guest. Brandy Herr is... Oh, okay, I think I spoke with Brandy. She's co-founder of the Granbury Ghosts and Legends Tour
in the
Granbury Paranormal Expo.
They were the paranormal people.
Mm-hmm. Intrepid Productions. The Weeping Angels.
Oh, DJ Crescent Doll.
Christian Doll.
Christian Doll. Was she there? I can't even remember.
Well, she was on the schedule. I mean, I don't know.
I don't know if that was Leftovers, because she was the one that brought the superior sound system, I think.
So, I mean, for a small con, they had a pretty decent lineup.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, not bad. You know, a lot of local folks.
Yeah.
You know, they had a nice little variety, plenty of actors, writer guy, paranormal, you know, people, you know, cosplayers. You know, so, no, I think, you know, for being a small show, for being a free event, you know, I think, you know, they had a nice little variety of guests to, you know, to check out or talk to or get autographs and all that good stuff.
That was my phone. Sorry about that, folks.
Nice.
If you heard that ring, yeah.
Nice.
It's my phone on silent, too.
Well, yeah, and you put it on the table.
Hey. Oh, well.
Yeah, but
what do you want to say about the guests?
I just wanted to see who they were.
Oh, you just wanted to run down the list.
Yeah, because it's like, I don't know.
You didn't care, come on.
Yeah, I didn't care. I'm sorry. You know, it's...
You just want to see the one artist guy so I can talk about pencils or whatever you talk about.
Yeah, we just talk shop.
Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, what was his name?
Drew Edwards.
Trying to find Damon Bowie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're just going down the list now of others.
Tigers, looking at their site, that donkey lady's just weird.
Okay, he's listed, but they don't have a link to his site or anything.
Ah, oh, weak.
Yeah, at least he's on the page. I'm not even on the freaking page. Okay. So.
Well, you should have paid more than $50.
Okay, to be fair.
Touche.
To be fair, okay, I have a question. Would you rather be not on the page or be Ed Quarto? Thank you, Sandra Fan.
I I know, right?
Well, these people are Mexican, so they should have been able to spell it right. They would know.
Yeah. Yeah, come on, man.
That's true. Bronies, I know.
That is a goofy looking doggy lady. I gotta give the props to whoever did that on their front page.
Hold on, let me pull it up so you can see just the image.
Okay, do not look up. Okay, I have to stress this. Do not look up donkey lady by itself on Google. You'll get some weird stuff.
Did you do that?
No, I didn't, but I can just imagine. Just go to the MonsterCon website, look at the background, and be happy with that.
Yeah, it is silly, and it is so amazingly goofy. I love it. I love it.
It's pretty good for a horror / funny convention. So, yeah. It's well done.
Yeah, I mean, it's a good place to go to have fun.
Fun way to spend a day or two. You know, it's free. Yeah.
Yeah, but you know, but bring your friends and get ready to you know have fun there, make your fun there.
Yeah, and if you like to dress up, then dress up, and you know have lots of kids, you know, or just people in general. You know, hey, that's an awesome costume. Let me take a picture. Or, you know, oh my God, Deadpool!
Oh my God, Spider-Man! Yeah, Spider-Man has swords and a gun. All of you will die.
Hey, times are tough.
I know, man. I was working for tacos, but now I'm gonna have other signs that says like "Yiff" or "Repent" or something like that. I don't know.
He's working on it, folks. Yeah, he's working on it. Okay, I think that'll wrap it up. I mean. Minor issues, but overall, a good show. Everybody had fun.
Yeah, stuff that can be fixed.
Like I said, mainly the venue, you know, just being a butt. You know, nothing new there. I mean, even the Book Fest had problems with the venue.
They're trying.
Mm-hmm.
They're trying, so.
Yeah. As far as the rating, I guess IGN would rate it 10 out of 10. Could be fixed, right, guys?
No. You know, I don't think we ever do numbers on the show.
I think before we used to do a thing, is like, would you recommend it or would you go back to it?
Oh, yeah.
That was our big thing. Like, would you go again?
It's 5 minutes away from me, so yeah.
Yeah,
I would go again, and I'm on the opposite corner of town from it, so, yeah, like I said, it's a fun way to spend a day, you know, hang out with your friends, you know, if you're a cosplayer or a fursuiter or what have you, and you can go and be seen, you know, have your picture taken and all that neat stuff. Yeah, I would definitely go and encourage, you know, locals to go. I don't know that it's worth driving from, like, another city to go.
No, definitely not worth another city.
If you're a local, or you happen to be in the neighborhood, then by all means, you know, go check out the NDG Productions events.
Yeah, I mean, we should have plenty of local people here to fill it up.
Yeah, exactly.
Anyways.
Exactly, so I think we'll wrap up the show on that note. And so on behalf of AJ,
later y'all,
and Chris,
see ya,
and myself, Eduardo Solis, this has been Con Talk episode number 45, and thanks for listening.